ocean breezes and that laid-back coastal lifestyle, we're exploring a Marine and Navy base on the shores of Jacksonville, North Carolina, a great place for families within a three-hour driving distance to some amazing coastal retreats.
This is the duty station, download across the nation. This is the duty station, download it, download it. This is the duty station, download it.
Welcome back to the Duty Station Download, where I give you the 411 on the best of what your next duty station has to offer. Today, we're joined by my friend, Laura Briggs, a future of work and freelance economy expert. She is a two-time TEDx speaker and the author of The Six-Figure Freelancer. Laura started freelancing during her husband's year serving as a doctor in the U.S. Navy. During his active duty years, Laura got to know two very different U.S. cities, and today we're chatting with her about her time when they were stationed at Camp Lejeune in Jacksonville, North Carolina. Hey, Laura, welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me here.
I'm excited that you came to talk with us about Jacksonville, North Carolina and Camp Lejeune. So tell me, what were your first impressions of Camp Lejeune?
Well, first of all, it's beautiful and the weather is great. You're coming from a colder location, just knowing that you're going to be on the coast of North Carolina is going to give you some clues that it's going to be a pretty nice environment. I think one of the first couple things that I noticed, one, it's primarily a Marine base. So it's a lot of also younger Marines, and many of them are just out of their first, out of basic training, or maybe they've done one other training stint somewhere. They usually haven't been in the military super long as far as the enlisted folks who are there, but there's also a really good officer presence there with lots of people who have plenty of military experience. I would say that it's very affordable because of the size of Camp Lejeune. That rental housing market is insane. You will have no problem finding a house that you like. We found a beautiful property within 10 minutes of the base. It had a pool, it had a massive backyard. It was everything we were hoping for in a property there. And so there's lots to choose from, right? We haven't always experienced that everywhere we've lived. It's a great area for families. And I would say it's sort of a, when you think about Southern or slower pace of life a little bit, that's definitely sort of the vibe of that area.
Oh, that's incredible. I know that really getting nested is super important to thriving at your new duty station. How long were you at Camp Lejeune?
We were there for a total of 3 years. We originally got orders for two, and then we extended for a year because we were super happy being there and there weren't any other sort of positions that had popped up that would really prompt us to move.
Yeah. So at what point in your career and in your spouse's career did you guys end up there?
So for my career, I had been working for myself. I had been working for myself as a side hustler for about a year and a half at that point, but I had been working full time for myself for about 7 or 8 months of that period. And so I took my career with me as a freelance writer. My husband, this was his first out of medical school, completed his internship in psychiatry. This was his first what they call GMO or general medical officer duty station down in Camp Lejeune. So he'd been in the military for quite some time at that point, but this was really his first full-fledged physician role where he was working in a clinic there. So yeah, there were lots of officers there, and my husband jokes because he did a lot of sick call and he was these guys are 18, 19 years old. There is never anything wrong with them. He's they're all ready to deploy. That was one of his primary metrics, is how much of the force there is ready to deploy at a moment's notice. And he really improved those numbers while he was there. But he was it was so easy because I was working with our healthiest military members in their prime of their lives.
Yeah, that's incredible. That's such a unique thing about his job and what was going on there. So before you got to Camp Lejeune, what did no one tell you? So what I'm asking is once you got there, you're hey, I wish somebody would have told me this about this place.
Yeah. I mean, we moved there. We came down over one weekend from Maryland to look at houses, and none of the houses we looked at did we like. So we totally put it in the hands of our realtor. And I feel like so many military families have gone through this, where the person is FaceTiming you or taking a million pictures, and you decide where to live completely based off of this random person's recommendations or the pictures they sent you. So we didn't know everything about the area. We'd only been there like 36 hours total. First of all, no one tells you that it's pronounced Camp Lejeune. You can tell usually who has been stationed at Camp Lejeune by the way they say it, because the way it's spelled, it looks like it's Camp Lejeune. And apparently it's named after someone whose name was pronounced Lejeune. And so that's why it you need to pronounce it that way. But they will correct you if you do not get it right when you first move there. So don't worry about that. I think what no one else told me is the sounds of training, just based on what they do. They do a lot of grenade training at Camp Lejeune, and they do it sounds like bombs like rattling your house, like not a true like overhead bomb, but it's enough if you don't have any furniture in your house yet that it's very loud and noticeable. And so it's even when you do fill your house with furniture, it will rock the whole house. Lots of helicopter missions going over the house, a lot of rifle and gun training. So it is almost shocking when you first move there, but it reminded me of growing up near a train track. At first it really bothers you, and then over time you just get used to it. And so you would get used to the bomb sounds of the grenades and the rifles going off all the time, and the helicopters with Marines hanging out of it doing training overhead. You get used to it. But yeah, also like just the officers club is so beautiful at Camp Lejeune, especially when they do their special holiday meals.
I love that. So if you're working from home at Camp Lejeune, plan your calls around the grenade training, right?
Yes.
Laura, please let our listeners and viewers know where they can connect with you.
Yes, please find me on LinkedIn under Laura Briggs. And I love connecting with other military spouses. So if you have other specific questions or concerns, like feel free to reach out and I'm happy to help.
Yeah. And you guys, Laura is an author. She's got several incredible books out, including The Six-Figure Freelancer. We will try to link those in the show notes. We absolutely recommend that you check those out. She is a wealth of information. All right, Laura, thank you so much. This has been another installment of the Duty Station Download. If you want to get in on the conversation about Camp Lejeune, you can send us an email at podcast@vertforce.us. We'd be happy to connect with you. If you appreciate this content, share it with a friend or another military family. Be sure to subscribe to our show so you don't miss an episode. Bye.